Vincent is a former U.S. Department of Justice and Department of Homeland Security counterterrorism official. He's now the Assistant Director General of International Policy at Borderpool, a coalition of border experts. Let's start there. I mean, in terms of skill sets, all I need is a wallet with a license and a credit card, go into Home Depot or a rental car place, rent a truck, drive and plow down a bunch of people. I mean, it doesn't take a certain skill set, and that's really difficult, especially if the person's a loner, for somebody in your shoes to try and figure out who is this person and when are they going to attack.
Mike, you're absolutely right. It's an extraordinary challenge. Vehicles that we've seen used, unfortunately and tragically, with great effect in places like New York City and Nice, France, and Berlin, Germany, and of course London, are very low-tech but extraordinarily lethal. We should be sad, we should be disgusted at this, but we shouldn't be shocked. Way back in 2010, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula, in its slickly produced web zine, Inspire, called on adherents to use vehicles, calling a pickup truck that had been modified the ultimate mowing machine. In addition, the so-called Islamic State's spokesperson and one of its original founders, Abu Muhammad al-Adnani, just a couple of years later, called on adherents and operatives to go out and to look for targets and not to depend or rely on bullets or bombs, but to quote him infamously, to slaughter them with knives, to crush their skulls with rocks, and to drive over them with vehicles. And as we've seen, that is exactly what individuals that have been inspired or directed or that are simply mentally deranged have done to kill innocent men, women, and children across the globe.
He's a 29-year-old from Tampa, Florida, apparently. We know that he's Uzbek national. You've been to Uzbekistan. Give me some background. What are your thoughts on that and the connection?
Mike, I have spent some quality time in Uzbekistan, and over the past few years, there has been an alarming and disproportionate number of Uzbek nationals that have engaged in acts of terrorism all over the world. Law enforcement and terrorism officials are trying to understand the particular psyche of Uzbek nationals that are living in Uzbekistan or part of the larger Uzbek diaspora across the globe. Uzbeks have lived, unfortunately, under the iron heel of a totalitarian state for many decades. And a number of individuals are feeling marginalized and alienated and disaffected and are perhaps looking for some way to lash out. Unfortunately, they're not engaging in peaceful protests in some cases. They're actually killing innocents outside of Uzbekistan. That is a significant challenge for officials, and I can tell you that we will take a closer look at what might be happening throughout Central Asia, but focusing again on Uzbekistan because of the significant and disproportionate number of terrorists that are coming out of that community.
Let me ask you a dual question. ISIS obviously losing territory in their caliphate. Are we more likely to see terrorist attacks as a result of that? And the second part of this is Emmanuel Macron, as you know, signing this legislation. It's very restrictive. A lot of people say, boy, it really infringes on people's rights. Are we more likely to see that in places like France, the United States, as we see more terrorist attacks?
Tragically, Mike, absolutely. You're precisely right. Because the so-called Islamic State has really been pushed out of, for the most part, Iraq and Syria, their bases. They are looking for opportunities to establish their continued viability. And they are doing that by having its adherents or individuals that are inspired carry out attacks in places like New York, places across the globe. And so as their so-called physical caliphate gets pinched, their virtual caliphate, unfortunately, still exists through the use of the internet. And individuals are being asked and directed to go out and commit these horrendous acts to establish that the Islamic State still exists and is still very much a lethal threat.
All right, Peter Vincent, thanks so much for coming in. Unfortunately, we see you all the time, and hopefully we won't see you anytime soon, but it's so sad to see more terrorist attacks, especially here in the United States.